Hi everyone, this is Kameshwari from Nalla Narasimha Reddy Education Society Group of Institutions, accredited by NAC and MBA. Today we are going to discuss about biomass management. What is biomass management? The term biomass management can be defined as sustainable utilization of biomass as a bio resource for energy generation without causing damage to the natural environment. The best available technology, that is best management practices, is applied in order to cause minimal environmental impacts and maximize the energy efficiency. What's that? In order to minimize environmental impacts and maximize energy efficiency. So here, biomass management involves the following aspects. What are those? The first one is ecological preservation. So further, it involves the protection and conservation of forest and other natural resources. Further, it includes maintenance of ecological sustainability, physical, chemical, biological integrity of the watershed, and also use of degraded land for growing plants needed for alternative fuels. The next one is encourage the social forestry activities, improve land use planning by shifting cultivation, use of organic fertilizers to enhance soil fertility, and also maintain biological diversity and ecological balance, and also increasing water storage, etc. What are the ecological preservation means? Maintain ecological sustainability, physical, chemical, biological integrity of the watershed, encourage the social forestry activities, improve the land use practices, that is by shifting cultivation, maintain biological diversity and ecological balance, increase water storage, etc. This is the one of the point for biomass management. The next one is biomass regeneration. Biomass regeneration. Here, biomass regeneration can be accomplished by the revegetation in the watershed. Biomass regeneration means accomplished by revegetation in the watershed, and also restoring of forest resources, adopting soil conservation measures, along with increase in production of annual and perennial crops, trees, etc. And one more thing is forest management and conservation. In this watershed management, main focus on trees. Why? Because of in that overall land utilized by using plan means in that cases we can conserve the more moisture content. It will helpful for plant growth, reduce the runoff, increase the infiltration. So automatically groundwater table will be increased. So forest management and conservation. So here forest management and conservation means include selective harvesting of forest resources, thinning of the trees in the forest, reforestation, afforestation activities by afforestation activities by natural or artificial regeneration. Branches and dead trees on the forest floor to encourage the growth of grasses which form the food for domestic animals. Forest management and conservation. Here we can include the selective harvesting of forest sources, thinning of the trees in the forest. So that thinning of the trees means we can utilize the area and growing the different types of crops, grasses and perennial crops. So that means which form the food for wild and domestic animals. Plant protection and social forestry. Here, the shrinkage forestry biomass resource should be restored by protecting the undeveloped forest from human and social forestry refers to community forestry development on unutilized common land or community-owned land to produce firewood, timber, in order to meet the needs of the local and also underprivileged peoples. It involves the planting of trees in government wastelands, panchayati lands, in and around agricultural fields as well as village common roads. Plant protection, social forestry. Here we can plan the, it involves the planting of trees in government wastelands, panchayati lands and also in and around the common lands. Increase productivity of animals. In this point, some of the various approaches to boost livestock productivity includes the use of new breeds, animal nutrient, and also improved rangeland and pasture management. And next one is income and employment generation activities in a watershed. In this point, human labor is needed in various agricultural activities. What are those? Preparation of land, sowing, transplantation, weeding, harvesting, transportation and other post-harvest management operator. Here, human labor needed for various activities for preparation of a land. Next one is formation of learning community. In this particular aspect, involves educating the public to change the attitude towards protection of watersheds. This is main point, educating the public The education programs can be designed in a manner so as to convince people about the benefits of watershed protection. These programs may include conducting educational workshops, videos, newsletters, and other printed materials, websites, and also formation of groups, advisory committees, monitoring and assessment of watersheds, etc. And better living standard for people. The proper utilization of local resources with less external input enable increase in socio-economical status and standards of living in people. And adopting eco-friendly lifestyle should be done to protect the health of the watershed. And also it involves adopting all the measures with the aim to check the factors responsible for disease transmission and to produce a clean and healthy environment to one and all. So this is the main one of the topic of biomass management. In this topic, ecological protection, biomass regeneration, forest management, plant protection, increased productivity, income and employment generation activities.